Thank you very much, Ma'am Claudine. Medyo na puputol-putol. Apologies for that po. Yan. So, okay. Today, for this week, there will be a bit of a switch up with regards to the schedule. The EdTech is going to be scheduled on Thursday, and the collab will happen today. Okay? So, yan po. We are nearing the end of our season 2 ng ating webinar series. Watch out, next week we will be announcing the next scheme. So after po ng ating May 30, season 3 na po tayo. Iba na po ulit ang scheme, nag-iiba din po ang mga demands and needs po ng ating university. So yun po. Yan. Without further ado po, today, as you have seen when we posted our poster sa inyong mga group chat, respective group chat, the topic is very timely, okay? Because we have transitioned from ECQ to GCQ now, and yan, we are nearing the point where we're going to be allowed to go inside the campus. But what are the protocols? I'm sure may mga questions po kayo. Our speaker is the first speaker that will discuss topic po sa area po ng Finance and Administrative Services. So very thankful po kami na nag-agree po si Sir. So without further ado po, the Director of the General Services Office, Dr. Nathaniel Golia. Hi, sir. Good morning po. Sir?
Po sa inyong lahat?
Ayan po.
Okay na po.
Sir. Apo, okay morning. Na po. I-share ko lang po.
Pwede na po ako mag-share ng Sir Paul?
Apo, sir. Pwede na po.
Oops. Yan po. Can you see na po, Sir Paul?
Yes po. Kita na po, sir.
Alright po. Good morning po sa inyong lahat. Magandang umaga po. Nats Golia po from the General Services Office. So I'll be sharing with you po protocols on security and safety and health in response to the existing conditions due to COVID-19. In case that or in the event that campus opens for the flexible work arrangement po that was promulgated by the HRMO po. So this will be a short presentation lang po. Reserve your questions po later. I'll be more than willing to answer your questions po. So, this is the GCQ edition kasi na-downgrade po tayo from ECQ to GCQ. Yung G po dyan, sabi nga po nila, hindi po yan gala, no? So, general community quarantine, no? According po doon sa omnibus guidelines released by the Interagency Task Force po on Emerging Diseases, GCQ refers to the implementation of temporary measures, limiting movement and transportation, regulation of operating industries, and presence of uniformed personnel to enforce community quarantine protocols. So yun po yung GCQ as an opening statement, Ignorantia, legis, neminem, excusat. Ignorance of the law excuses no one. So para sa akin, an informed Lasallian is a better Lasallian po. So, basically, the General Services Office and the Campus Safety Office recommended po the protocols on security, safety, and health in accordance po doon sa guidelines set forth by IATF. So, let's go directly to the general protocols po. While the general community quarantine is in effect, the work schedule, entry in the campus, and other related matters shall be governed by the following po. Under the assumption po that The campus is already open and the flexible work scheme will start na po, no? So number one, for work schedule of staff and academic service personnel or ASP, the guidelines of the Human Resource Management Office shall apply po. Ipapaliwanag ko po yan. Secondly, for the reporting of faculty members and classes of students, the memoranda issued by the Office of the Vice Chancellor for Academics and Research shall be observed. And number three, for the entry of employees who are not part of the skeletal force, a request endorsed by the Vice Chancellor concerned may be sent through email to GSO for approval po. So number one po, yung pong mga staff saka mga ASP, their names have been submitted to GSO po, yung pong part of the skeletal force. So once they enter the campus po, they will present their ID and the security personnel will counter check po with that the list given to us whether that person or that staff or that ASP is part of that list. Kung kasama po sa list, papasok po, no? And also ang mga empleyado po, ang mga staff ay required to log in gate 1 using the logbook provided for by the HRMO. Wala pong kinalaman po sa amin sa security yung kanilang logbook. It is the logbook of the HRMO, no? So lahat po ng staff, ulitin ko po, ay magla-log in doon po sa pagpasok nila sa gate 1. For the reporting of faculty members, no? The Office of the Vice Chancellor for Academics and Research provided us with a list of faculty members and staff who will be reporting for specific dates. I believe each college is assigned a date or dates for their entry in the campus. Ang tanong po ay siguro, paano po kung wala sa list yung faculty? Yun nga po eh, pagpasok nyo po sa campus, kaya nire-iterate tayo, magdala po kayo ng ID, kasi yung ID nyo po, check namin sa amin. Actually, yung list is provided for by the college, no? And endorsed by the Vice Chancellor, yun lang po yung tinatanggap namin at yun po yung binibigay namin sa security personnel to counter-check if you are part of that list. Ang siguro po, paano po kung wala sa list? Again, number 3 would apply. Ano po yung number 3? Posible po kasi na inihabol yung pangalan nyo doon sa pwede mag-report, hindi lang po naisama doon sa unang list, you will be allowed entry. So give us time po sa gate 1 to verify with the college dean, for example, or head of office, if you are being included in the list of those who can enter the campus. Ano po? So the crucial part is the ID po. No? Siguro may magtatanong po, para saan pa yung certificate na pinurbide ng HR? O HRMO, the certificate is for the checkpoints po outside of the university. Hindi na po namin kailangan yung inyong certificate. Ang kailangan na po namin yung ID because we have already the list po. So moving on, ano ba yung mga health protocols na you observe when the campus opens po? Strict wearing of mask upon entry and while inside the university po shall be implemented. Thermal scanning of body temperature shall be done in every point of entry. Those with body temperature of 37.5 degrees Celsius and above. Meron po yatang sounds to sa kasama natin. Shall be advised to go home and seek medical assistance. No, so, para din po protektahan naman ang bawat isa sa atin. Kung kayo po ay hindi na maganda ang pakiramdam, pinapakusapan po namin na huwag na rin po tayong pumasok sa loob ng campus, no? Para sa inyong kalusugan at para din sa kalusugan ng mga nasa loob. So, yun po. All points of entry. Kung mamaya po, i-discuss ko yung mga points of entry. Those who feel unwell while inside the university shall be brought to the university clinic for initial medical intervention. However, suspected COVID-19 patients shall be advised to follow government protocols in seeking medical assistance, including undergoing tests. So kung kayo po ay nakapasok na, dahil nung pumasok po kayo ay okay naman po kayo, nakaramdam po kayo ng hindi maganda, you can call the clinic or you can call the campus security office or you can call GSO and we will go to you po and we will pick you up and we'll send you to the clinic po. And from there po, we will, the doctor and our nurses will assess your condition po. So, ang tanong, may clinic ba pag nag-resume tayo ng flexible work arrangement? Yes po. Magbubukas po kami. Siyempre, limitado rin po yung mga nurses na tatao sa clinic, no? To commensurate din po yung dami ng tao sa loob ng campus. Of course, proper respiratory etiquette shall be practiced. Our EMRT shall be on high alert, roaming the campus during work hours po. They are equipped with face shields, face masks, and gloves, no? And will attend to those who will feel unwell during their entire stay inside the campus. Physical distancing of at least 6 feet shall be observed. Ang sabi nila po kasi ay 3 feet or 1 meter eh. Pero sinubok po namin kasi yung 3 feet saka yung 1 meter. Pag bumahing, aabutin po kayo ng bahing eh, o ng atsing eh. So hanggang maaari, para ho ligtas din kayo, at least 6 feet po para ano, malayo-layo tayo sa bawat isa, malaki naman po yung campus eh. Face-to-face meetings and conversations shall be discouraged. I believe this is already contained in the memo of HRMO. Mass gatherings in any venue of the university shall not be allowed during the GCQ period lang po. Pedestrian gates shall be provided with alcohol or sanitizing gels, while soap and sanitizing gels shall be available in restrooms po. Moving on, safety and security protocols po, ito po. This is adopted in the memo of HRMO that all visitors shall accomplish the visitor's health checklist. Ito po ay adopted din naman sa form ng Department of Labor and Employment, no? So kung meron po kayong mga bisita na darating during the GCQ period, in case again that the campus opens, the requesting party, the employee of the university shall be the one to secure the visitor's health checklist and ask the visitor to accomplish the short form. May pila naman po yung form, mga may health questions lang din po doon. And submit through email the form at least a day before, no, ng pagpasok noong tao to GSO. In lieu of the hard copy of the permit to enter form, so ibig sabihin may permit to enter form at merong visitor's health checklist, ito po ay maaring soft copy na lang na isend sa GSO. Meron po kaming fillable form ng permit to enter na you can use for this purpose, no? Ang crucial lang po dito, ang gagamitin dapat ng employee na mag-request ng entry ng bisita ay dapat yung kanyang DLSU-D email account. The same request, permit to enter form, should be furnished ang head of office and the office of the vice chancellor na under po yung employee. And address to GSO at dlsud.edu.ph, no? Copy furnished din po ako sa nsgolia@dlsud.edu.ph, no? And we will act upon your requests immediately po. Time of stay and movement in the campus shall be limited to what is indicated in the request para lang po sa mga bisita. Properties to be brought inside and outside of the university shall be coordinated with GSO. There is a property declaration form for this purpose. Ito po ay lumang policy na. Only vehicles with university stickers shall be allowed entry in the campus. Mahigpit po ba itong ipapatupad? Hanggang maaari po, papatupad namin po yung no sticker, no entry policy, no? Pero kung sa kalagayan po na urgent talaga, isang beses lang naman gagawin ang pagpasok, Sabi niyo lang po sa security na magko-coordinate kayo sa akin at pupuntahan ko po kayo doon sa point of entry o tatawag po ako doon para po kayo ay ma-accommodate. Third party providers and their suppliers shall be governed by existing policies and the provisions of these protocols when applicable, unless added safety and standards are required of them by the unit, office, or provider they are servicing. Halimbawa po yung mga nasa construction, if they are allowed to work under the existing omnibus guidelines po, ay meron pong extra requirements sa kanila, no, ang mga offices na kanilang sinusuplayan. Moving on, saan ba ang pasok at labas natin? Kung kayo po ay may dalang sasakyan, your point of entry will be at gate 4 po, magtagumpay, no? If you are exiting the university, your exit point will be at gate 2 po, magpuri. Kung pedestrian po kayo walk-in, your entry point will be at gate 1, no? Magdalo. So, paano ba ang ruta nyo? Pag may dala kayo ng kotse inside the university, so if you are from gate 4, entering gate 4, kung papunta po kayo ng ano, papunta po kayo ng museo complex or yung heritage complex or sa Ayuntamiento de Gonzales, diretso po kayo papunta doon sa road in front of Julian Felipe Hall, mga ngaliwa po kayo doon, tapos at the corner, alam niyo na naman po siguro kung paano ang ruta nyo, kakaliwa kayo, at makarating na po kayo sa Ayuntamiento de Gonzales hanggang doon sa Heritage Complex. Kung kayo po ay papuntang from Gate 4, yung rotonda, tapos ang diretso nyo na po dyan ay yung Paolo Campos Avenue Road. Ito po yung road in front of ICPC, sa kanang alumni building. Paolo Campos Road po yan eh. So, manganganan po kayo sa may Acacia Road, yung sa may Polka. Tapos, mangangaliwa po kayo, makakating kayo sa CBA. If you are going to Gregorio Montoya Hall, yung old admin building, ganun pa uli. From Paolo Campos Hall, imbis na kumanan po kayo sa Acacia Road, diretso lang po kayo, tapos at the corner of West Avenue. West Road pala, West Road, ay kakanan kayo papuntang Gregorio Montoya Hall. Kung kayo papunta ng dorm, mangangaliwa po kayo. Ang Lake Avenue po ay mananatiling sarado, maliban lang po kung magkakaroon ng traffic sa loob ng campus, no? So, I hope that is clear po. Will there be transportation? May echo po na konti. Request for transportation may be granted subject to existing government regulations and institutional precautionary measures in response to COVID-19 crisis. Ang ibig pong sabihin, sa GCQ po kasi, limitado ang movement ng mga sasakyan at meron lang mga specific purposes ang pinapayagan sa ilalim ng omnibus guidelines po ng Interagency Task Force. So, kung pasok po kayo doon sa, sorry po, kung pasok po kayo doon sa guidelines ng interagency at kailangan nyo ng sasakyan, naka-standby po ang transportation office to serve you, no? Basta ho ay pasok, I would like to reiterate that, pasok doon po sa guidelines, yung omnibus guidelines ng Interagency Task Force. Ngayon po, while inside the campus, in case of any emergency, medical emergency, please contact the campus security office at 3279. At kami po ay re-responde sa inyong mga pangangailangan while you're inside the campus. Ayun po. I will entertain questions po later, pero pwede ho pahabo lang ng advertisement. On June 1, pagkatapos po ng season 2 na ba ng, ano, ng webinar ng CILP, we will be opening, yes, naman po yung CEPOC. Apo, so sasabayan po namin yung webinar para meron din po kayong ibang online courses na pwedeng kunin. So, GSO in partnership with CILP is bringing you CEPOC. It is a community emergency preparedness orientation course po, offered online through school book. No, open po siya sa lahat, faculty, staff, and students for free. Meron pong 14 courses online, no, from fire incident to bomb threat to active shooter incident to communicable disease outbreak, no, etc., etc. Equivalent po ng 8-hour session ang bawat isang course. Tapos pag natapos niyo po yung 14 na courses, mini courses, you will be given, syempre, you will be certified as a CEPOC certified, no? So, please email me at nsgolia@dlsud.edu.ph if you are interested to take this course po. Libre po ito. You can take the course in any order. Wala pong prerequisite. Ayun po. Shout out lang muna po bago kong pasalamat. Shout out lang po sa mga kasama po namin sa FAST group na naglilingkod po sa inyo dito sa campus kahit na during the time of the ECQ hanggang ngayon po sa GCQ. Nato po kami sa Lasal. Of course, sa ICTC, sa BFMO, sa ERMAC, sa Finance Office, sa HR. At syempre, mga kapatid namin sa academics, saka sa mission and advancement, no, for all the support. At syempre sa security team namin ng De La Salle University Las Marinas. Again, thank you and keep safe and secured. Animo La Salle po.